I like to call my OCD the what-if machine. It's what generates all the unsavory questions my obsessions, well, latch onto and obsess over. It can start with innocent questions like, what if I left the coffee maker plugged in? And then escalate to, what if I ran into traffic? It makes those with OCD feel like crap. Why, then, do we accept these questions, these feelings? Honestly, it's hard not to. It'll sound convincing. Maybe I did leave the coffee maker plugged in. After all, I use it practically every morning. But the thing is, it doesn't stop there. The questions keep going. They keep building. If I did leave the coffee maker on, then maybe the cord will malfunction and the kitchen catches on fire. Then maybe the house will follow. But those maybes feel more certain. Like a given fact. These things will happen if I did this one thing. Because I did this one thing. Thoughts spiral. Your brain is pumping out questions and unreasonable assumptions one after another after another. It's hard to get loose from that anxiety spiral once you start falling into it. So where do these questions come from? I, for one, am not keen on running into traffic, but the thought still echoes in my head. It's based on things, simply put, that freak you out. The idea of, what if I did that? It's that idea that spurs the compulsions forward. In practice, this is labeled as thoughts being ego-dystonic, a fancy way of saying, there's no way I do that. That's terrible. It's just that a person with OCD gets their what-if machine going into overdrive, makes them think, there's got to be something I can do to shut down this train of thought. And wham. In comes compulsions. Those weird things that folks with OCD do. It's to stop the what-if machine. What everyone should know is this. People are not their obsessive thoughts. Just because a thought occurs, that doesn't mean that it has any power to do anything. Being afraid or anxious is okay. It's hard to feel that way, but learning to sit with it is a good step to take. Sit with it? I hear you exclaim. Yeah, that's the first step to combating this anxiety. Now, I know well from experience that sitting with the anxiety is far from a cakewalk. The thoughts can escalate with the anxiety, and it's a cycle that feeds itself. Those thoughts can seem deafeningly loud, too. They just keep bouncing, seeming to become more real, the louder that the thoughts become. How do I stop the house from burning down? How do I convince this weird part of my brain that it's wrong? This train of thought seemingly occurs as much as the obsessions themselves. Just make my brain normal. Make it so this broken record of disturbing thoughts and imaginings stops. It can be hard to think of being on the other side of this disorder while being in the thick of it. The thick of all these thoughts and these compulsions. The idea that the main way to stop OCD is to just keep feeling that anxiety until it fades away seems like too much of an ask. Yet, that's it. The main way of dealing with OCD is just don't do it. I know that even though it's the main way to deal with obsessions, just rationalize your way through the anxiety isn't always an efficient way of dealing with it. It feels like you're screaming at an upset avalanche of thoughts. They still come no matter how hard you rationalize them. For me, it felt like I was mentally beating at a brick wall for how often these rationalizations seemed to help at first. The brick wall will chip and crumble, though. It takes time, patience, and a lot of willpower to get through to the obsessive thoughts in one's brain. But sometimes, that doesn't feel like enough. And it's like, just as fast as that mental wall is being knocked down, another one's being built or strengthened. Another obsession is taking the old one's place just as fast as that gap in brain power is being realized. More seemingly irrefutable arguments in one's own brain. This is where a third party, like a therapist, can help. Having someone on the outside of this all-too-internal argument can be a huge help. Not only can a therapist see another side of OCD, they can often help you come up with ways to fight it on your own. It might seem scary to talk to someone about your obsessions, That's understandable. If they're alarming to you, it could be terrifying to think of how those thoughts will come across to other people. But at the end of the day, therapists are there to help people. To help you. Know and remember this. OCD does not make you a bad person. You don't have to feel alone in your thoughts. There are people who understand, and people that can help. OCD is a scary thing to go through, especially alone. So reach out. If you have any subjects about mental health or LGBTQIA+ topics that you'd like to see covered, please let me know down in the comment section. As always, resources are listed in the description below. Thanks for watching the OCD Enby. Stay safe out there.